Once upon a time, on a tiny group of beautiful islands in the center of the Pacific Ocean, about a half a century ago, when rulers and their first ladies were proud to live in luxurious palaces, a very tall, very pretty young Filipino country girl was swept off her feet by a handsome young lawyer who had a wild and crazy ambition to become president of his country. He promised his innocent bride a dream beyond even her most insane imaginings. That pretty little beauty queen was to reign as First Lady of the Philippines for 20 years and become the richest and most infamous woman in the world. Her name is Imelda Romaldez Marcos.
Ferdinand Marcos and his beauty queen wife Imelda were installed in the presidential palace in 1965, where with the support of the U.S. he ruled for 20 years, while the poverty level in the Philippines rose threefold. His corrupt and cruel regime allowed Imelda to live a luxurious life in the Malacanang Palace, spending billions on parties, entertaining everyone from Saddam Hussein to George Hamilton. The threat of communism gave Marcos the excuse to declare martial law, and for 10 years his deeply corrupt presidency notched up over 10,000 reports of torture and abuse. Imelda continued to increase her hoard of jewelry, including the $5 million Idol's Eye diamond and her notorious collection of some 3,000 shoes. Finally, after the assassination of foremost political opponent Ninoy Aquino in 1983 and the consequent people's uprising, President Reagan withdrew U.S. support and the Marcos family was exiled to Hawaii. Ninoy's widow, Cory Aquino, became president. In 1990, after Ferdinand's death, Imelda was tried in New York on fraud and racketeering charges and was acquitted. But the Filipino government claimed the Marcoses had looted the country of at least $5 billion and sentenced Imelda to a minimum of 24 years in prison. Out on bail pending appeal, she claims the money is their own and that they invested it in New York real estate and various bank accounts all over the world for the benefit of the Filipino people, and that evidence of this is contained in Ferdinand's dying will. So far, she hasn't produced the will. But Imelda has returned to politics in the Philippines as the congresswoman for her home province of Leyte.
We're entering Imelda's abode, her humble abode, because she was in her townhouse, very small, tiny, vault and braised marble townhouse. We're going here. Okay. Gracias, amigo. Little joke. I know they don't speak Spanish. Buenos dias. Thank you. Hello. Here we are. What floor is Imelda? Does she have a buzzer?
No, but you get pressed on.
How do we know where we're going?
Here.
All right. Somebody who psychically knows where she lives.
Okay.
What floor?
24.
Is she friends with the neighbors?
Yeah.
Does she go over there and borrow, like, milk?
Yeah.
When she runs out of groceries?
Does
she just go over to the neighbors in her slippers and her bathrobe and say...
No, nobody sees her in slippers and bathrobe.
Nobody?
Nobody.
Otherwise, what happens?
No, she doesn't come out of her bedroom in slippers and bathrobe.
Has she ever seen herself in slippers and bathrobe?
Yes, she does all the time.
Okay, just so somebody has.
Yeah, well, okay. Also her nurse.
Right.
And her
secretary.
What
does she need a nurse for?
Because she's 66 and she has a heart condition.
Some people are just starting their life at 66.
She is.
She's well, ready to cha-cha.
Yeah. No, I don't know. She
might be in a bad mood, is what
you're
saying.
No, she might not. She might not take kindly to it. Might affect your interview if we come in shooting.
Okay, so let's not come in shooting.
It's too strong. It's too strong.
Okay.
So you just stay here and I'll go in here and tell them you're
okay. Hello. Hi. Thank you. Oh, thank God she has air conditioning. Do shoes play an important role in your life, Imelda? You think that's a bad first question?
No, yeah. Because the shoes...
Come on, lighten up.
The shoes only came up after the revolution.
And who's this by? This is a Pizarro. A little-known artist, methinks. This is the real Pizarro.
I'm
going to
so?
Scratch the surface.
No.
What? They're fakes here. They're lying. They're fakes. What else have we got? So who's done the decorating?
She.
Good taste. Here's art. This is Imelda's house. Look at Imelda's. Got a sense of the Woolworth about her. And here she is with... What? Saddam Hussein. Look at him.
That's Gaddafi.
God, Clive, why are you telling me this?
Hey, look, this thing's next to him.
There's Saddam Hussein. There's Gorbachev. There's Mao Zedong with his head turned because he's shy like that.
This is Doris Duke.
Doris Duke.
That's
Jimmy Carter. Look at him. And they're sharing a laugh there.
And there's your prime minister?
Not mine.
Oh, they're prime
minister. I think you'll find he's been out a few years. And this is Nixon. Look at him there in a lighter mood. He's still laughing. God bless him. Who's he with? Fred.
President Marcos.
Ferdinand. President Marcos. I can call him Ferdinand. Who's this?
That's the king of Saudi Arabia.
King of Saudi Arabia, Mountbatten. Wow, she's got some
Castro.
Photos of her. Castro. Imelda did not hold back with her party people. Where's
and
Castro?
And the Paradiba. There.
There's Castro. Can you pick it up?
Yeah.
Castro with Imelda. Look at that. Look, she's so comfortable.
She's not nervous about meeting me, is she?
Oh, shit. All the pictures are falling apart.
Help me.
Uh-oh. I'm sorry. Hello.
Welcome.
Nice to meet you. Thank you very much.
She was correct.
What
a lovely lady.
Oh, no. And I
what
heard you
privilege.
Were very pretty.
This is very overwhelming.
I know. Sorry. I'm sorry.
We invite ourselves.
Yeah. What I would...
May we... this is...
See, they never gave you credit, if you pardon my interruption, for the good things you did.
Well, I thought a mother having
No, they appreciate you being the mother, yes. And a fabulous mother you were.
But,
you had three children.
But I, it is the a matter of perception,
right.
and the same thing with my late husband. Of it was really a misperception.
What was the misperception?
Misperception was Marcos was a great Democrat, a great. Freedom fighter and a great
libertarian.
Libertarian but, and then a humanist. And
why did he get so misunderstood? This is what we want to know. What karma, you do believe in karma, happened to you?
No,
that
it's
you
not,
would be so punished.
In the case of Marcos, it's not. It was not really the karma, because karma is something that comes back.
Well, it also means you must have done something terrible for you to be punished this much.
No,
and punished as
I think
are.
It was a mis. We are now in a. In a world wherein you are coming into a world of information,
yeah,
and then you perceive people in a different way because you come from the east and from
think,
the west.
You think
and then
from the east, west, we think of your husband in different terms
no,
than they do from the east.
There is a misperception. Like for instance, it is true right now. Let us say it is 12 a.m. in the Philippines,
right?
But it is 12 p.m. In America.
Yes.
It's a completely, and yet it is true that it is so at a given time.
Mel is playing with relativity and truth now, aren't we?
Yes, but this is exactly what is
the book is.
Circles
well, some
life,
things,
something.
What do you define then as a truism? I mean, do you believe in reality? Seriously?
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. And not only, but at the same time, we believe in reality, and we don't look at it in what is right, and what is good, but we look at it from the point of view of a balancing act.
Yeah.
Because everything in this world comes in pairs, good and bad, yin and yang.
Right.
And
so, do you think you maybe did a little bad, a little good? It was a combo special.
Well, when you come in for when you are being perceived on by the West from their point of view.
Right.
Then.
You
it
haven't
will
got
be
a
different.
Chance.
You
yeah.
have no chance.
Yeah. But in this country, just for the reality, and then we'll move on again, mm-hmm. is that you're up for, you have about 300 convictions against you?
Not really 300 convictions, 300 cases.
And you want to come back to this country that's convicting you for that?
No, this is my home.
Yes, I
it
know.
It is natural for me
Are
to come home.
Are they crazy here?
They talk about Marcos, about this negative force, and yet when I came back,
they cheered.
After all the... vilification and relentless persecution
yes.
that Marcos is in the media and everywhere. Millions of people
embraced
me
you.
And
you said, and they said you got bruises of love.
Yes,
and your arms
so,
from
that,
being kissed by
and
the
so,
people.
And then when everywhere I go, the people come.
Why do you think? Do I call you Madame Marcos?
But whatever you want.
Well, Imelda. They used to call you Meldy when you were
yes,
little.
Yes, yes.
How
yes.
old were you then? I'd like to picture you as a little Meldy.
Well,
when you were a little girl.
Many people still call me Imelda today.
Yes, I won't call you Imelda.
I have not lost my child.
I feel a little bit of Imelda in there somewhere.
But,
why does the country love you so much? Why are you mobbed when you go into the streets? What is it about you that they love so much?
Maybe I'm transparent. Maybe they know what's in my heart. Maybe they know
that
I love them. If Imelda can do it,
sure,
everybody can
do
it.
That's probably
why
the people
like
love
share.
You. They think if this little girl can come up
yes.
and pull this stunt, this
yes.
this great
yes.
piece of work, then anybody can.
Yes, if this is, it's a matter of attitudes, values.
Now, just let's go back. When you were a little girl and you grew up on Leyte.
Yes.
Leyte, where you're now the congresswoman.
Yes.
Well, that's fantastic. And now, I'm a little confused. Did you start off wealthy or did you start off poor?
Our family was neither.
And you were, of course, going to be, and perhaps maybe should have been, a great singer. Well, you played bigger houses than Sinatra.
Good evening. I'd now like to introduce my very special guest. Ladies and gentlemen, Madame Imelda Marcos.
The sun should tumble from the sky, if the seas should suddenly run dry, if you love me, truly love me, let it happen, I don't care. If it seems that everything is lost, I will smile and never count the cost. If you love me, truly love me, let it happen, darling, I won't care.
Here was a girl from the countryside. And she had a dream.
A simple
all
girl.
My dream.
Remember, this was a simple girl.
Yes. She had a dream. All her dream was to have a little house with a picket fence by the sea. Little did I know that I will live in Malacañang Palace for more than 20 years.
Must have go cost to a all lot the of major.
When Marco saw me, he wanted to be introduced, but nobody wanted to introduce
beautiful
him to
story.
Me because they thought, you know, this is not the girl for you because he had. Really quite an eye for women. Half an hour after we met, he proposed marriage.
No.
Yes.
In the canteen.
Right in
very
the canteen.
Very erotic.
And then the next morning, the 11 days after, we were married.
No. That's
yes.
fantastic.
We met
that's
and
the
got
perfect
married.
Way. He'll never know the bad news until after you're married. And then it's too late.
Well, the bad news?
Well, if there was any bad news, which obviously there
thanks
wasn't.
Thanks God. Oh, it was I think that was a marriage made in heaven.
What was your job back then? What were you doing?
Basically a housewife.
You did a little hoovering around the house. You did the cleaning.
He gave me an engagement ring, 11 carats. Then we went on a world tour for 1 year for a honeymoon.
Did you suspect that he had money at this point?
No, because I always considered myself a girl for the country and very close to nature.
Right.
And he liked that. And suddenly marrying a politician was so public. And I asked him, why do we have to be in politics? He said he wanted to be president. I said, why do you want to be president? He said, because that's where I can maximize my wealth and my potential.
Did you want to be a simple girl?
Well,
I
did
farm?
That. I could not say that, but I really could not stand politics. But when I was being brought to almost yearly after we got married to New York for
psychiatric
almost I was on the verge of a breakdown.
Well, what made you crazy then?
The doctor told him, he said, your wife is really not sick, but there's nothing wrong with her except that she's rebelling against this very public life politics. And he said to Marcos this, and I was about 10 feet away. And then immediately said, if that is what will
cure her and make her healthy, I give up politics
for her. He said that for you?
Yes.
In fact, a few weeks ago, I was interviewed and somebody said, Mrs. Marcos, you're still in cloud nine. You're still dreaming and fantasizing. Yeah. Actually, we think you're crazy. I think you're... Are you crazy, Mrs. Marcos? And my answer to them, I think I am.
Made this song, composed this song in a plane going to Russia. For the president, Marcos. I love you. I need you. I miss you. My love. I dearly love you. When you're away and unbearable loneliness overwhelms me, because you are me, my darling, I love you beyond life, and my love be yours forever.
Ferdinand claimed that he'd discovered the so-called Yamashito gold in the Filipino jungle, hidden there by Japanese generals in 1946. It was this legend that he used for his excuse for being so rich, a story as mythical as his war record.
When he went to politics, he had already quite a stash of precious metals.
And did you really discover it because he used to cover the gold in lead and he
it was really the old gold bullion was covered with lead.
Right. And the walls of the house that he moved in were built, were made out of this stuff?
Yes. And then I tore it down, not knowing what was in there. Because I wanted the house to be spacious.
So one day, Melvin, let me get this straight. You got a hacksaw and started hacking the walls down?
I got it all out. I had it all out, all the things, all these walls down, because it was so crammed up and then walled. And so I threw all these things outside. And when he came that day, he said, where is the wall? He was so scared. I said, I threw it out. And then he said... Where? So he ran there, and to my surprise, it was gold bullions that was covered with lead. That was the way it was before.
So all the rooms were partitioned by actual gold covered.
Almost all.
Picture hanging. You didn't ever hit anything there?
No.
No suspicion that the walls were made of gold?
Well, because the walls were also covered with books. With books, it was
clever.
Yes, that's right.
So now you must have just gone through the house tearing the walls down. Wait a minute.
No.
What's the furniture made out of? Is it legal to have gold bullion in your house? I mean, is that legal?
At that point, yes.
Yeah, it is. But they were only angry because there was no tax on it. I mean, because he didn't declare tax.
No, because it was not sold.
Oh, I see. You don't have to pay tax.
They were all in place.
If you just have it in your house.
Yes, yes. You know,
that's where everybody gets so angry, because the tax was not that
high. But that is what we use. That is what we used for our government. It was all in place worldwide, because we just placed it there. Sorry.
There's something in your throat. Sorry. So I see. Ooh, I didn't realize you had to.
Pardon the machine.
She's choking to death. I'm talking too fast.
Oh, mercy, don't you doozy, don't you little lamps to die me, and kill life at you, was it clear?
The devil cats.
Oh, mercy, don't you doozy, don't you little lamps to die me, and kill life at you,
silently.
If the word sounds queer and funny to your ear, a little bit jumble and jiving, sing verse it old and does it old, yet little lamps to die me. Oh, mercy, don't you do it, don't you leave lamps of diving, and kill ivy too, wouldn't you? And kill ivy too, wouldn't you?
But she has scars on her hands.
Oh, well, we're not going to look at the scars.
No, she's proud of those scars.
Oh, is this from when they attacked you with the knife?
Yes. They were going to plastic surgery this.
No.
And
a little dimple in the arm
but
from
my husband said, no, 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 that's your badge of courage.
So what happened? You were doing a thing for the beautification of the Philippines.
Yes, and I was parrying this.
So he was coming at you and you're fighting with your hands?
On December the 7th, 1972, Imelda fought off an assassination attempt on live television.
But you had a bulletproof bra, which I thought was
No, there was none.
There was no bulletproof bra?
There was none.
I saw a photograph of that, then they fixed it.
No,
I thought it was great that you had a bulletproof bra. I was going to ask, where could I buy one?
It would be making me fat, and that was terrible.
No, you're
that's
too
worse than
that.
Death.
Too vain for that. Oh, you know what? Can I just, before we do anything else, do you mind me touching you?
Oh, go ahead.
I'm just hiding these scars. Please, I'm begging you. This would make my life.
Yes.
Can I see your shoes?
Oh.
It would make my life.
Not.
I'm begging you.
My face is you know,
go,
I've been traveling.
So go home. Fix up the room, and then we could maybe see it. No.
A shoe?
Show you my shoes. I'll come with my shoes tomorrow. What are your shoes like today?
You
these
know, most
nice.
Of my shoes... Oh, my gosh. Most of
she's
my
shy
shoes
about
really
the shoes.
Are espadrille. I don't know why they made such a fuss of the shoes. Thanks God, you know.
Because she had 3,000 shoes. Nobody in the world ever had 3,000 shoes.
No, but Mrs. Aquino got it all.
Mrs. Aquino has 3,000 shoes?
They
is
have
she
not,
your size?
That she... That they, she it was in
ask
the palace.
Her.
And then...
Mrs. Aquino is traipsing around in your shoes.
This is probably the room that has shocked people the most. Here you will find about 1,000 gowns, 1,500 handbags, and a bulletproof bra. And now for her world-famous 2,600 pairs of shoes. In one interview, Mrs. Marcos claimed that the reason why she had so many pairs is because she wanted to help promote the Filipino shoe industry. As you can see, they're mostly made in France and Italy. And the sad thing about this is that the average per capita income of the Filipino is roughly the cost of one pair of her evening shoes.
They poured through the gates without resistance into a palace which they regard as the equivalent of Hitler's bunker. Within minutes, Aquino supporters began throwing state papers from the palace's windows. Others destroyed photos of the ousted first family.
I had such a taste for really great art and beauty because I was so intimate with nature. All this that had been left was kept not in the museum by the government. This was kept by our maids and servants.
Oh.
And who believed that these were beautiful things and Mom loved this.
The maids and the servants came to, where did they rescue
them from? These were in the slum areas kept by the maids.
No. Where did they go in to rescue them from? The museum?
No, it was still in the palace.
Oh, they were in the palace,
and
where everybody could see them.
When we were taken, they took this. These are the favorites of Mom, so they kept it. They kept it for so many years. What was in the hands of the poor came back to me.
No.
But what was in the hands of the government was sold away for nothing.
So what else did they save? They saved the pictures, and they did they
this
save
is only a few.
And they saved some clothes. Did they save some jewels?
They did. It was the poor that saved my clothes, our home, our things.
Oh, look at the screen. What's on the screen?
This is actually.
Is this you as a child? This is your act.
No. This is my first trip to China.
What was Mao like?
Funny, because from my distance, he was a great humanist. And yet, this is the same guy who said that power comes from the barrel of the gun. The same guy
who gave me a
gun and I'll give you a village. And yet, he was so humane in his treatment with the people around him, with us.
Well, that's how people are sometimes. You meet them in person,
well,
and they're
so
nice, but they were actually killers.
And that's how my first day with Imelda ended. No sign of the shoes, but I wasn't giving up. Originally, I was only allowed to have a half an hour interview, so I must have passed some sort of test, because she invited me the following day to accompany her to church and to bless. the poor.
Mr. Marcos, is it possible we can put a microphone on you, please?
Sorry, son.
So, I just want to put a microphone on Mrs. Marcos. If you just, you know, okay?
Maybe the thing that I'm being struck electrically.
Okay, now I need to put the microphone on. Can we just a bit of decorum in here, lads?
Mrs. Marcos is being wired now. She was frightened that we might electrocute her. Paranoid little woman. And I said, no, this is for weight reduction. That we're wiring her for sound. She's very paranoid.
No, don't move. There's equipment.
That's what you're showing. Oh, no. Don't film that.
Did you film that?
That's
what
you're doing.
What's new? Well, I'm one of those rare creatures who need very little sleep, about 2 hours.
Really? That's very lucky.
Very lucky.
That's why you had such a good nightlife. Well, you did.
Yes.
Do you do exercise?
You know, I do all the wrong things. I don't exercise. I eat a little more than I should.
What's your favorite
and the wrong
exactly?
food.
What do you eat?
Problem is I like everything.
Are you one of those people that doesn't know when to stop?
More or less.
I am too.
I'm very disciplined in almost everything.
But food? Now, I read your book.
Yeah, I read your book last night.
And I thought I could just ask you a few things.
Surely.
Would you mind?
Surely.
First of all, I think the book's going to be a bestseller.
Believe in your dreams. They are as real as your heart. And when you've fashioned them from your imaginings, they fade to comparison to the realities they can become. You can make them happen. It is the enchantment within you, the mystical power, the energy force that shapes genius and nature together. Divinity's illumination, like a shaft of light, swaddling your brain in glorious brilliance.
Oh, that's wonderful. Swaddling your brain in glorious brilliance. Did you write that?
The mathematical stuff is fascinating. You know, Imelda's done all these kind of little squiggly things here, like kind of hieroglyphics. There's a lot of symbols there, and they all mean something, like the ecological order, the human order, the cosmic order. Can you see that? This is a symbol of peace.
This now is peace, when you say peace.
Yes. You're going to be writing another book.
Well, hopefully. This time, more or less, a chronicle of how events came. But after all, you
everybody
know...
Everybody wants to know. Or how to marry a dictator in 11 days or less. I love what you said about your mother. First of all, that when you were at school, because your mother died when you were very young, the only drawing of a mother that I knew then was the image of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Whenever I prayed, it was her name. I said, Mama Mary. In school, I was told to behave like her, to be Mary-like. And do you believe that you've stayed Mary-like?
Well, I had no other symbol. And I lost my mother early on.
Yes.
And so I had to create my own mother. I could not read yet. I was a little girl, and I did not know about the great women of history.
And did you picture
and the
your
first
mother
thing was,
as Mother Mary? Religion.
Yes.
Did you?
Yes.
And did you ever have, and they do have them, visions. Did you ever see?
Of course. I always, in fact, when I was interviewed once of all magazines, Playboy, and they asked me, who is your own mother? I said, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and they laugh.
Thank you.
all is forgiven.
Do you believe in abortions here?
No, we don't believe. We don't really believe any killing. Any termination of life.
Why does Cori Aquino hate you so much? Because of her husband?
I really don't know, because I
mean, did she, before her husband was assassinated, were you friends?
I only met her once, and that was when I visited her husband a few hours before he left, because he wanted to leave. He said
he
was sick.
New York.
And to left the States. And I arranged everything, got to clear him papers in spite of his real conviction.
But he knew
because
if he came back here,
because
he
had
killed.
Conviction, because they found truckloads of dead people, massacred people in their hacienda.
That's how dead people in the hacienda.
Massacred people in Hacienda Lubecita. And that's the reason
that's
why.
True.
Marcos did not put him just for political reason. He was no threat politically to us.
In 1983, Marcos's longtime political opponent, Benigno Aquino, flew home to the Philippines to harness popular discontent. He was shot dead as he stepped from the aircraft.
So he comes back and he's shot on the runway.
Oh, yes.
Who shot him?
Well, first of all, that's not culturally that Filipinos don't do. Shooting in mid daylight.
Right. Who does do shooting in mid daylight?
I really don't know.
Czechoslovakians. It had to be those Czechs.
Day three. Today's the day she takes her oath as Congresswoman, and she's invited me over to the house where her and Ferdinand lived before she moved into the palace. She no longer stays here, as she told me it breaks her heart to remember the days where they lived as a young couple. She's so sentimental. You know those photos that you see in the Inquirer where you see a mass of bodies that have just been gunned down? That's what this house has the feel of.
So this is where Imelda lived when she wasn't in the palace. Lifestyles of the rich and famous. Come here, quick, this way. Wow. Look at this. Madame lived well. Check it out. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, how are you? Are you friends of Imelda?
Yes.
I hope so, otherwise
yeah,
you're not.
Hello.
Hello, you've been true. I'm a friend of Imelda's too. Hello. How do you do? This is the BBC.
Hello.
We just look on the walls here. This must be him. They're watching television. And this is Ferdinand.
Hi, Ferdinand.
There's Imelda with the family. And Imelda, in a slimmer day, there she is. And of course, who Imelda based herself on, the Mother Mary. There's Ferdinand playing golf. Look at him in a little jovial mood there.
She flew in from the island, from Leyte.
Oh, you're from Leyte. Yes, are you happy she's taking the seat?
Yes,
are you happy?
Of course. Yes. She is a government official herself, a very strong lady.
Do you know Imelda's plans for Leyte about putting them all on the internet?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
On the computer. This is me. This is me. What did Imelda do? She put a spear through my teeth. There's me. It's not a good picture. I'm much more attractive in real life. Oh, and here's Imelda. I'll just hold it. I'll see if she notices. Hello. Oh, no, it's your day. Let's not do... Did you know this? This is me, and this is me holding a baby. It's not really mine. I thought it would look good in the picture.
Oh,
today is your day, though. I did not plant this magazine here, by the way.
I thought you did.
No, it was here.
No,
I'm
just kidding. I saw this.
But you are giving your speech today.
nice. Most probably not. That's exactly what I wear all the time.
I know, the same shoes. Pair. I've changed my shoes in 3 days, and you've stayed in the same old pair.
Yes,
I think that's saying a lot.
Because I really, even as first lady, this was not one of my,
I'm famous for my shoes. I think you should come out of the closet.
I don't know.
Is she Meldy to you?
Yes.
Is she Meldy to you?
Yes.
You went to school together then?
Mm-hmm.
Did you think she'd come this far?
Well, even in our high school years, the light was there. Probably it started there and it continued.
You knew she had something going
yeah.
then?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, first, she was really different from all others.
Taller?
She was taller, slimmer, beautiful. And
don't
you
hold
know,
back.
She
smarter?
She was, well, yeah, of course.
She was the president of the...
Student Council.
In college. Divine Works
did she
University.
Really win, or did she, you know, play around
no,
with
no,
the
no.
there?
Because we worked for her.
So she was the prom queen. She was the popular mm-hmm. girl in school.
Yes.
So you knew even then.
Mm-hmm.
It is me. I haven't raked it. And I did not plant it in the house.
There's been attempt at settlement by both parties.
Yeah.
Because after 10 years, this Marcos thing should be all behind
right.
us and
what
we can
we're
move
talking
forward.
About is that the Philippine government would like some of the $5 billion that's missing back, or they say is missing. And so I read that Bongbong said
yeah.
he would bring some of the money in from Switzerland or
you
wherever
know,
it is.
What's funny is it's been established that there is money someplace belonging to the Marcoses, but the strange thing is they can't locate where it's from
right.
or what's missing, because they can't locate anything missing.
Well, this gal was obviously not good at facts and figures, was she? She should have written it down.
No, put in money somewhere.
You should know where it goes.
No, what I mean is the Philippine government can't locate anything that they're missing
right.
to account for how come the Marcoses have all that much money.
Right.
So you see, you can't say he is rich, therefore he is a thief. You can only say that if you know where it is. I lost something, you have it, therefore you're a thief.
Sure, but if your pants are gone and they were worth $5 billion and they're gone, you know it's missing. Where it is irrelevant.
Yeah, but the Philippine government to this day cannot prove that they're missing $5 billion.
Oh.
They claim Mrs. Marcos has $5 million. They
billion.
Cannot claim they're missing $5
oh, right.
billion.
Okay. But that's what the problem is. This is why she's going to court all the time.
Yeah.
Somebody's imagined that $5 billion is missing.
It's under
here. Maybe it's in your mouth. It could be maybe
oh, wonder of wonders.
Could be anywhere.
Imelda Marcos arrived in court with her flamboyant cowboy lawyer to hear the jury's verdict after a trial which had become better than a Broadway show for most New Yorkers. Imelda faced the three-month ordeal alone, dramatically collapsing once a month under the stress of the court appearances.
One, two, three.
$350,000 documents presented by the prosecution during her trial in New York.
Oh, really? Saying why she was innocent?
No, they were saying why she's guilty, and then they acquitted her anyway.
Why she's guilty? And she won anyway?
Yes.
Is this her accounts?
The alleged accounts.
Oh, you mean they made up 350,000 documents?
Yeah, not made up, but, you know, they presented.
Well, they must have come from somewhere.
Oh, these are just
figures.
Repairs,
I would never
know.
Somebody went through all these documents.
Office supplies, scotch tape.
Is this what they claim the $5
yeah.
billion went to?
Yeah, scotch tape.
That's a lot of scotch tape.
Glue.
Oh, yeah. These statements are checks for Saunders A. Cam. Do I get beheaded if she walks down here and I'm looking? This is unbelievable. Checking account statement. But it doesn't say for what, Saul. Oh, these are like prints of checks. Copies of checks. Oh, that's fabulous. This is like the Turin Shroud of checks. I think I know why she got off. Your photocopy stunk. I think that's why she got off. Who could read any of these checks? If you guys had a decent photocopy machine, the woman would be behind bars today. I've sorted it out, haven't I? And she works for her. She's laughing. Chain gold, stick pins gold, Rolex watch. Price, $6,412,000. Am I going to get in trouble for this? Here's ring, 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 and this bill is for $149,000. Wow. Ear clip mountings, $1,700.
In about 10 years, they haven't found anything.
What do you mean they haven't found anything?
They haven't proven anything.
Is there any... Do you know where the money is?
Yeah.
Where is it?
Switzerland, I guess. That's what they say. But they haven't proven anything.
But you think it might be in Switzerland? Is it like the Loch Ness Monster? Or is it...
Something like... Well, it could be...
Do you think she has money in Switzerland?
Well, there is money in Switzerland, but I don't think it's hers.
Whose is it then?
It's probably the Filipino people's money.
Yeah, I just want to know, why do you think nobody believes her? I mean, most people, when they're acquitted, the world would back off. Why does nobody believe that she was not responsible for spending all that money?
What do you mean?
Okay. Why do you think the world still thinks, or even I ask this question, because usually when you're acquitted, you back off. Why does the world go on saying, where's the $5 billion?
The argument here is stolen.
See, all right, you think she had it from the Yamashita gold?
Whatever it is, she
was
they
had it.
Right. They had it.
And what? It's Ferdinand's money? Ferdinand's gold?
Maybe.
Well, you could say a shipment came in from Joe Blow. Right. It could have come in, but whether it's Ferdinand's or not.
It came out here. It came out of the Philippines.
Right, but we don't know who it came from. That's not great documentation.
Yeah, but they presume it's his.
Right. If you own the money, why be ashamed?
Maybe waiting for a golden age for the right time.
To break it to the world. I've never heard, believe me as an American, anybody who hid their money.
Well...
And look at the repercussions it's had.
Well, see, culture is different.
Right, okay. I knew you'd fall back on that one.
Society's
yes, you're just innocent people who know nothing.
You know.
Imelda, at last,
beautiful,
was ready to be sworn in as Congresswoman for Leyte. What a moment.
Fantastic. Oh, there she is. Look at her. Oh, we can't see her. She's wearing that black glass. But she's in there, Blanche. So, is there security in the truck, Saul?
Like all former first ladies of the Philippines, she has two policemen officially assigned by the government.
Right. But somebody's packing some heat.
Well, those two policemen.
Right, okay, good. Because I'm feeling a little twitchy. I don't know about you. Just
no.
A titch twitch.
No. You saw how much he's loved.
In the church, now we're going to the government seat. It's slightly different.
And I refer to none other than the Honorable Imelda Romualdez Marcos.
Oh, I have a pass.
On go with your mom. You are not allowed inside.
I'm not?
Please.
Do you know who I am?
Mama.
I have a television show.
Yes, Mom, but...
BBC.
It is our rules, Mom.
It is. No, you've got a point. I was teasing. Come on.
Thank you very
Where's
much.
Where's your sense of humor? These guys. She doesn't remember her line. I'm just going to prompt her. Because I have the script. I don't want her to dry. You know what I'm saying? Oh, she's wearing it. She's wearing it. Look at how happy she must be. I bet she never dreamt this day would come. You know, you do a screw up like, well, look at her. Who would think it? It just goes to show someday OJ may be president. Hello, there's my boyfriend. Look. Wait, here's my what do you do?
Are you very I sit here.
Are you very powerful?
No.
I won't deal with you unless you're very powerful.
Really, really.
I think you are, otherwise you wouldn't say things like that. I spotted you up there. You were gorgeous.
Thank you.
How have you been?
Are you married?
About a
What's your star sign? Come on, tell me. See you later. I'll see you after the Congress. I'm in. I am so in, it scares me. I'm just talking to the daughter. Are you very pleased that your mom won?
Yes, we're delighted.
Are you?
Yes.
Did you ever think you'd see the day?
Well, yes, we knew it would come, but it was a long wait.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, so are you very happy today?
Yes.
Good. Are you going to follow in your mother's footsteps?
Probably not.
Why not?
Some of us are not made for this.
Really? You're more the delicate touch. What do you do?
I'm a musician by trade, but generally I'm a mother.
A mother. Well, your mother's a mother.
Thank you.
Can
Can I say congratulations?
Oh, thank you so very much.
I won't ruin your makeup.
No, you won't.
Well, she's back.
Yes,
look out. Imelda's brought out the Christmas decorations, and it's only October, so you know she's overexcited. Ever since Imelda saw me on the cover of Hello, I have become her best friend.
We have everything here.
Kiddish and breathlessly childlike, she invites me upstairs to see the bedroom. No one's ever gone there before.
Wow.
That's nice.
This is an old bed of the family.
Have you got a hard bed here? Let me just try it. Mattress
like
is a
hard bed.
Very hard bed. I'm a soft kind of cushion girl. Yeah. I like those soft. Have you ever tried a water bed?
It's very difficult for me because I can't seem to get out of it afterwards.
Well, you need help. A lot of people have to come and lift you.
This is an old, old bed, most probably about 200 years old or more.
This is where she munches at night. Imelda tried to hide these, but we found her. A little late night munching there, so she likes those Fritos. Oh, no, Imelda, look at this. Fabulous bathroom, and I'm glad it's clean. Look at this. So we get in the jacuzzi.
Well, it's
we always end in that jacuzzi. Can I just... I won't scratch the marble. I just like to... always feel it, feel it. If I could get Imelda in here, I've got a coup. Not a coup as in an overthrow, just a coup career-wise. What toothpaste does she use? I know people will ask. Platinum. Colgate Platinum. And some jacket. Of course, you're very... You always need some baby oil, I think, when you're a world leader. That's always important. We may have to cut that. Okay, so where next, Imelda? Imelda's toilet. This is her loo. This is her flusher. This is her mirror. This is her jacuzzi. These are some of her free products. She got these when you... A lot of, Imelda stole some towelettes. What, the woman can't buy a towel? She went on an airline and got some towelettes. Take the towelette. Souvenir from Imelda's bathroom. Where else? This is Mr. Marcos's room. Look, this is where he watched late night television. On his humble little television set.
You know, that was his television set.
Can I lie on this?
I'm begging
you. Oh, look at this. Heart again. It's still too hard for me. Well, it's good. I'm glad you married him and not me. It's very hard.
Yeah.
Come on up.
That's the attic, really.
Oh, please, can we go up?
But it's a mess.
I want to see a mess. Everything's been too neat. You really like to see the other side. The other side of a Imelda. Okay, bingo.
Not at all.
This is fantastic. Just from here. You know how we waited? Here we are. Okay, just from here. Just the beginning of the treasure trove.
I had found the holy grail. The shoes. And many, many, many there were.
And
these were just the beginnings of the new hoard.
They have not unpacked yet.
I know, but they're still... Look, they're in couples. You know, you haven't got them all mixed up.
It's all
close, 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 close. Close, close, close. This is the happiest I have been since Zsa Zsa's closet. And funnily enough, these look the same. Zsa Zsa has this outfit. Oh, my God. Are these her clothes?
You are naughty.
I think loud colors are de rigueur for Imelda. Her ballet collection. Okay, she's shouting, go, go. She may have had a lot of them, but were they tasteful? That's all I want to say.
I'm sure. Who would have ever thought they were hidden in the attic?
All I had to do now was find that missing $5 billion. But that would have to wait for next time. In 2 years, when she runs for La Presidente.
We got to the shoes.
And so our fairy princess may still live happily ever after.
I wish I never met you, boy. You never, never come again.